You're not quite sure what there is to do in Baton Rouge? Well, you're going to learn today. What's up, everybody, and welcome to the channel. This is Living in Louisiana, and today we're talking about seven fun things to do in Baton Rouge. Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Shaun Ramos, and I'm a licensed real estate agent in the state of Louisiana. So if you have any questions about making the move to or making a move in Louisiana, make sure you hit me up. My number is at the bottom of your screen right now. You can give me a call or shoot me a text, and I am the one that will answer all those calls, texts, and emails. If it's your first time checking the channel out, welcome. And while you're here, make sure you subscribe and click the notification bell, because I'm going to be cranking out lots of videos that are all about moving to or living in Louisiana, and more specifically, the Baton Rouge metro area. And as much as I do love making these videos for you guys, I would love even more to help you with your real estate needs. So if you have any specific questions about making the move to or making a move in Louisiana, please don't hesitate to reach out. So let's get right into this. So the title of this video is seven fun things to do in Baton Rouge, but I don't have seven specific things as much as I have seven different categories with specific examples of each. Number one is shopping. If you like to shop, then you can shop till you drop here in Baton Rouge. You've got lots of choices, both indoor and outdoor, and I'll go through a few of them. First is Town Center at Cedar Lodge, and that's in the kind of Bocage, Mid-City South area. It's an open air shopping center, so you've got lots of shops where you can buy anything from clothes, shoes, jewelry, flowers, even cigars. There's lots of different salons, spas, gyms, a pharmacy, and even a dog daycare. And while you're here, you can grab a bite to eat. There's everything from a donut shop all the way up to fancy steakhouses and everything in between. And if you really like it here, then there are condos and apartments. As a matter of fact, they're tearing down some of the old retail space and moving some tenants around so they can build another 286 unit apartment building. All right, so if you want to take it inside and enjoy the AC, you're going to want to check out the Mall of Louisiana. This is the largest mall in Louisiana, and I didn't know this until recently, but it's got the third largest indoor carousel in the world. Since they built the mall in 1997, they've done some additions. In 2008, they built what they call the Boulevard, and that's about 25 outdoor shops and restaurants. And then in 2019, they built the main event, which is a large family entertainment center that has arcade, bowling, laser tag, pool tables, and that type of thing. And it's even got a restaurant and a full bar so the adults can have fun too. And back when I was in high school, before the Mall of Louisiana existed, Cortana Mall was the place to be, but that has since been torn down, and there is a big Amazon fulfillment center coming up. It's gonna supposedly provide over 1,000 jobs in Baton Rouge. And if you're looking for something a little more upscale, then check out Perkins Row. It's right in the middle of Baton Rouge's medical and shopping district. I would say this is Baton Rouge's premier mixed-use development. It's got a great blend of shopping, dining, office space, entertainment, and residential living with the condos and apartments. There's a Fresh Market grocery store and an LA Fitness gym. If you want to get out of the city and into the suburbs, and check out Tanger Outlet Malls in Gonzales. It's got about 50 stores and a couple restaurants. And then also there's Jubin Crossing in Denham Springs. It's another mixed-use community with lots of shopping, lots of restaurants. It's got a movie theater, and there's also apartment buildings right now. They're still building in this one, so the plan is to have over 100 stores with single and multi-family housing. Number two, if you like to get out and enjoy nature, you've got some options in Baton Rouge. The Bluebonnet Swamp Nature Center is over a 100-acre facility operated by Breck. It's got an exhibit building filled with live wildlife exhibits and other displays, with over a mile of gravel and boardwalk trails so you can check out the wildlife and their different habitats. You've also got the LSU Hilltop Arboretum, where you can check out some of the Louisiana native trees and shrubs, and really, it's just a quiet place where you can just get away from everything. And the LSU Ag Center Botanic Gardens has an expansive collection of specialty gardens, woodlands, and wetlands. It's got about 3 miles of walking paths that go through the Bourbon Woods and five different gardens. Of course, you've got the public parks. So Breck maintains over 180 parks in the area with different types of facilities. And lots of these have nature trails and fishing lakes. Number three, if you want to get out and be active, then you've got lots of things to do right here in Baton Rouge. If you're a golfer, you've got over 30 top quality golf courses to choose from in the Baton Rouge area. But if you're looking for more of a climate controlled situation, then Top Golf is where you're going to want to be. So there you've got TVs, and you've got people bringing you beer and food. So, you know, that may be the better option, and you don't need your own clubs, and you don't even need to be good at golf. Or check out Uptown Climbing. So it's a state-of-the-art facility, and it's Louisiana's largest climbing gym. They do offer a members-only fitness room, yoga, and climbing instruction if you want to step up your climbing game. Now, I haven't been to Uptown Climbing, but I have been to Civil Axe Throwing. I was expecting this to be a little tougher than it was, but it was really easier to learn than I thought it would be. They don't serve alcohol is the only downside, I would say, but there is a bar next door where you can buy your beer and bring it over. Now, this is the only facility like this I know of in Baton Rouge, but if you venture out, I do believe they have one in Hammond and Gonzales, and there are two coming to Denham Springs soon. Back to the break parks we were talking about, you can hit the mountain bike trail. So there are two mountain bike trails that I know of, one at the Comeet River Conservation Area. It's a 5.5 mile long trail that runs through the 100-acre park along the Comeet River. And then you've also got Hooper Road Park that has a trail that's over 5 miles running through their 200-acre park. Number four, if you're somewhat of a party animal, then there are lots of places you can throw down in Baton Rouge. So you're gonna wanna check out Third Street. It's in the heart of downtown Baton Rouge. It's the hub of bars, live music, and restaurants. So you're guaranteed to have a good time, whether you're in the mood to hang out on the patio with a few drinks at Happy's Irish Pub, do a little dancing at Boudreaux and Thibodeau, or catch a live band at the Basin Music Hall. And once you work up a little appetite, you got plenty of food options from more upscale spots like the Little Village or Struby Steak and Seafood, sushi on the rooftop with a view of the Mississippi River at Tsunamis, or you can just grab a slice of pizza at the pickup window at Schlitz and Giggles. All I know is if you do leave Third Street hungry, then it's your own fault. If you go a little too hard and you need to spend the night, you can check out the Watermark Hotel or the Courtyard by Marriott right there on Third Street in the middle of everything. Or you've also got a few more options right around the area. I actually stayed recently at the Hilton a block away because it had a really nice view of the Mississippi River. Now, the craft beer scene is also going strong in Baton Rouge. MidTap is right off Lee Drive, right down the street from LSU, and there's a Mid-City Beer Garden on Government in Mid-City. Also, a few breweries you might want to check out. There's Rally Cap on Pennywood, so that's a local brewery featuring 16 taps of house-made beer. You've got Tin Roof on Wyoming Street. That's between downtown and LSU's campus, and they've got 5 regular brews to choose from with seasonal brews throughout the year, and you can rent this whole place out for parties, events, and meetings if you want to. Also, check out Cypress Coast on Government Street. You can catch a Saints or LSU game here, enjoy some live music, and maybe even a little karaoke. Number five, the sports. So like I said in a different video, we don't have any professional sports teams here in Baton Rouge, but it's a pretty short drive if you want to head to New Orleans and catch the New Orleans Saints or the New Orleans Pelicans. But Baton Rouge is very much a college town. There's always something going on at LSU between baseball, softball, basketball, tennis, gymnastics, or track. But LSU football is king around here. There's something special about being in Death Valley on a Saturday night. And even if you can't make it inside the stadium, check out the tailgating. You're guaranteed to make some new friends and have an awesome time. Number six, if you're feeling lucky, then we've got a few casinos where you can test that luck. So in downtown the Mississippi River, you've got the Belle of Baton Rouge and Hollywood Casino. Fun fact, when I just turned 21 and Texas Hold'em was really popular, I was in the Belle of Baton Rouge, was actually called the Argosy back then. I was in there before and after work every day. I may have had somewhat of a gambling problem, but I didn't really lose much money, so I don't really consider it a problem. If you head about 15 minutes south downriver, you'll find La Berge Casino and Hotel. So this built in 2012. It's a 7,400 square foot casino with a resort hotel. It's got a rooftop pool with poolside service. There's a full service bar and in-room massages. They got really good food and there's always some sort of entertainment. Number seven, there is a long list of museums for you to visit in Baton Rouge. There's definitely too many for me to list here, way more than you can visit in one weekend, but pull it up on Google Maps and you'll find a long list to work your way through. All right, so as you can see, it's getting dark on me out here. Baton Rouge has lots to offer, but I feel like I've given you enough now to keep you busy for a while. Hope you guys found this helpful and enjoyed the video. And if you haven't done it yet, make sure you subscribe and click that notification bell so you don't miss any future videos. And don't forget, I am a licensed real estate agent in Louisiana, so as much as I love making these videos, I would love even more to help you guys with any real estate needs that you might have. So check out that number at the bottom of your screen right now. Shoot me a text or give me a call, and I will be happy to talk to you. I am the one that answers all the calls, texts, and emails that come through, and I love having these conversations with you guys, so don't hesitate to reach out if there's anything that I can help you with. So until next time, you guys have a great week, and I will see you on the next one.